So with a lot of us stuck at home lately, I wanted to introduce a recipe that's gonna be versatile and easy to make without sacrificing any flavor. And so for me, the obvious choice was a braise, because you can basically just get it started early in the day, let it cook for a few hours, and it'll be ready by dinner. Plus, it lets you take any relatively tougher cut of meat, along with the vegetables and herbs that you probably already have on hand, and turn it into something super flavorful and delicious. And the technique itself is super versatile, so I'm using short ribs here, but like I said, any relatively tougher cut of beef with a lot of fat and connective tissue would work really well. And you could even use other types of meat too, like chicken or pork, by using the same process but just adjusting a few ingredients here and there. So I'll leave a couple variations that I would recommend in the description below, but for today we're going to be making red wine braised short ribs. So the main piece of equipment we'll need for this recipe is a heavy bottomed pot, preferably an enameled Dutch oven. You don't want to use a normal Dutch oven because the acidity of the wine might cause the pot to impart an irony flavor into the sauce. But anyways, we're gonna start off by browning the meat, so heat up your pot over a medium to low heat and add a small amount of a neutral oil. We'll also need to season the meat, so just coat every side with a generous amount of salt and pepper, because this is the only time we're gonna add seasoning to the meat itself, so we wanna make sure we add enough. Preferably, you'll want to do this at least a few hours or up to a day before you plan to cook the meat to really make sure that the salt penetrates all the way through. Now, for the short ribs themselves, I have about 2 pounds here, and I like them cut into small pieces like this, about 3 to 4 inches long, so they fit more easily into the pot. If you can only find the full ribs, you can just ask your butcher to cut them up for you into smaller pieces. Now is a good time to prepare the veggies too, so here I'm using a classic mirepoix of 1 large onion, 1 large carrot, and 2 stalks of celery. So go ahead and just roughly chop them all. You don't have to go crazy here because they're gonna get strained out at the end anyways. We're really just using them to impart some flavor into the sauce. So once your pot has heated up a bit, go ahead and turn it up to a medium-high heat and throw the short ribs in, starting with one of the fatty sides down to allow that fat to render out. Then after a few minutes, rotate each piece to brown the next side and repeat that process until every side is nicely browned. Remember, it doesn't need to be cooked all the way through yet, we're just developing some flavor on the outer surface here. So, as I mentioned before, if you're not using short ribs, any sort of tough, fatty cut of meat should work really well for braising. That fat provides a ton of flavor and prevents the meat from drying out, and the longer, low-temp cooking method allows that tough meat to break down over time, which creates a really delicious, tender result. So anyways, once the meat is thoroughly browned, just remove it onto a plate for the time being. You can see that there's already some nice fond forming on the bottom of the pot, which is gonna give our sauce some really great flavor. Now we're gonna take advantage of some of the fat that rendered out of the beef by using it to cook the veggies. Feel free to drain some fat out if you think you have too much, but in my case, I've got a pretty good amount. So make sure your pot is at about a medium heat, then throw the veggies in. We want them to sweat but not really brown yet, so add a good pinch of salt, not only for flavor but to help the veggies release their water, which will slow down the browning. Feel free to add a bit of neutral oil along the way too if the veggies are looking too dry. As those cook, we're gonna prepare the next addition, and typically in a recipe like this, you'd add some tomato paste at this point to add some umami and depth of flavor, but I'm gonna recommend taking it a step further with a few more additions, based on an idea that I picked up from Kenji Lopez Alt's pot roast recipe in his book, The Food Lab. He suggests adding, in addition to the tomato paste, a couple of anchovy fillets and a bit of soy sauce, both of which are super rich in umami and are gonna provide a lot more depth and diversity of flavor to the sauce. So for this, I'm using a mortar and pestle, and I'm first combining the 2 anchovy fillets with about a tablespoon of soy sauce in order to easily crush up the anchovies. Then add about 2 tablespoons of tomato paste and continue to crush and stir until everything is incorporated. If you don't want to do this, you can just use 3 tablespoons of tomato paste on its own, but I'd recommend giving this a try. Anyways, once the veggies are softened, just add your tomato paste mixture to the pot, along with about 1.5 tablespoons of flour, which will provide a nice nutty flavor and thicken the mixture even more. Now just let that cook until everything is nicely browned and some good fond starts to form on the bottom of the pan. Then at this point, it's finally time to add the wine. We're gonna add 1/2 bottle of red wine here, preferably Pinot Noir for a beef bourguignon type flavor. Obviously, you don't wanna use anything too expensive because you'll lose a lot of the nuances in the wine by the time it's done cooking, but you don't wanna go too cheap either. It should be a decent drinkable wine. Now just add the short ribs back and bring that mixture to a boil, being sure to stir frequently to release all of that nice fond from the bottom of the pot, then reduce it to a simmer and keep it there until the wine is reduced by half, which should take about 20 minutes. At this point, you'll also want to start preheating your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit, which is about 180 degrees Celsius. So now is a good time to prepare our last additions, which will be our herbs and aromatics, along with some chicken or beef stock. For the herbs and aromatics, I'm going to use 6 sprigs of thyme, 2 bay leaves, 4 sprigs of parsley, 2 sprigs of rosemary, and 6 cloves of garlic. I just cut the garlic cloves in half here, but there's no need to chop the herbs or anything because again, they'll just end up getting strained out at the end. Now for the stock, it doesn't really matter whether you use chicken or beef stock, both will taste good, but preferably you'll want to use a homemade one. Unfortunately, I don't have any homemade stock made up right now though, so I'll just have to make do with what I've got. If you're in a similar situation, you could use canned stock or even just plain water if you're really in a pinch, but I've found that using bouillon cubes gives me the best results. So here I'm just dissolving 1 chicken bouillon cube into 2 cups of water for my makeshift stock. Now once your wine has reduced by half, go ahead and add all of your herbs and aromatics along with your 2 cups of stock or however much stock it takes to almost completely cover the meat. Feel free to take some freedom with the herbs and aromatics that you use too, so you could substitute the rosemary for example with oregano or sage and the results will still be great. Anyways, at this point we'll just let the mixture come to a boil, then it's time to transfer it to the oven. I like to lay the ribs with the bones facing up like this and then flip them halfway through to make sure everything gets cooked equally. You'll want to put the lid on your pot, but leave it slightly cracked to allow some moisture to escape, which will help to both control the temperature in the pot and allow the sauce to reduce a bit and become more concentrated. So just throw them in your 350 degree oven for about 2.5 to 3 hours until the ribs are super tender and falling apart. In the meantime, I'll just show you how to make some quick mashed potatoes to go with the short ribs. These two go really great together, and between the two of them, it can make up your entire meal if you want. I'm planning to make a more in-depth mashed potatoes video in the future, but since that's not the focus of this video, I'll just go through it quickly here. So I just took about 1.5 pounds of russet potatoes and cut them up and boiled them for about 25 minutes until they were really soft and falling apart, then removed them into a bowl and added a few tablespoons of butter along with a few good pinches of salt and then just mashed with a fork. Then I added about 1/4 cup of milk and continued to stir, then added more butter and salt to taste. So that's it, they're actually super quick and easy. I like my potatoes a little chunkier, but if you want them really smooth and silky, you could even get out an electric hand mixer and smooth them out that way. So after about 3 hours, the ribs should be all done. You can see that they're super tender now, and some have even fallen right off the bone. So go ahead and remove the meat to a separate plate for now, and then all that's left to do is strain the sauce. So using a fine mesh strainer set over a bowl, just strain off all the vegetables and herbs. Now you'll see a thin layer of fat form on top of the sauce, so I'd just recommend removing as much of that fat as possible because you don't really want it in your sauce. Now just taste the sauce and add salt and pepper as necessary, and serve. If you want to learn how to make some dinner rolls to go with your short ribs, be sure to click the video on the bottom of the screen.